As the two of them went on together, Isaac spoke up and said to his father Abraham, "Father?"
"Yes, my son,"
Abraham replied. "The fire and wood are here," Isaac said, "but where is the lamb for the burnt offering?" When God asked Abraham to sacrifice his son to him, Abraham immediately declared himself willing to follow the Lord's command. Abraham had to walk for 3 days with this incomprehensible command of God in his heart. We don't read of Abraham offering all kinds of excuses, as Moses did. He simply did exactly what God asked of him, despite the fact that it meant the end of all his dreams for the future. While Abraham traveled for 3 days on this painful path, thousands of questions must have filled his thoughts. How could God possibly expect this kind of sacrifice from him? What plan could God possibly have with bringing this kind of suffering into his life? How could it possibly be for his own good to kill his son? But Abraham never voiced any of these questions. He also did not travel the road to Moriah by himself. Isaac was with him, and he also had to answer Isaac's innocent questions. "Father, where is the lamb for the offering?" Abraham's answer shows us his trust in God. "The Lord will provide, my son." And God never disappoints those who trust in him. He indeed provided a ram to be sacrificed in Isaac's place. God also wants to provide for you when you have to travel on a path of suffering. Trust in him to fulfill his promise. Lord Jesus, I know that I'm not immune to hurting and suffering, even though I belong to you. But I also know that you will be with me when things are bad, that you will hold my hand, and that your arms will be around me. Thank you for knowing me so well, that you see every one of my tears, that you also know of each one of my problems, that you understand me so well because you yourself were a human being who knew suffering. Lord, I have even discovered that this suffering is good for me because it draws me ever nearer to you and teaches me to comfort others in turn. Please help me when the suffering becomes too much. Give me your strength so that I can preserve and endure. Make me willing to take up my cross and follow you. Thank you for the certain knowledge that the suffering in my life can never have the last word. I cling to your promise that my suffering will one day in heaven be something of the past. Amen.